Right, so this is a new tutorial, and in this tutorial I'm going to make this gear. And as you can see, there is a lot of variety, and there is a lot of types in the gear. And as you can see, we have some which is has around 8 teeth, and which one was which has around 24. And what I'm going to make is to make one different. And let's go to our main interface and start by making a circle. So the circle will be here, and let's see that we has a radius of 0.05 and a vertices of 24. And then we will zoom by clicking on the period, and let's make it active. And after that we will I will extrude scale shift Z around 2 times, maybe scale shift Z 1.2, and then I will select all, make sure it's flat, and extrude in Z axis around 0.02. So I have extruded around 1 centimeter, and then I will select all these faces, and then maybe I will select 2 loop cuts and scale in shift Z. After that I will select these faces by selecting Alt and left click. Then I will select inverse or shaker deselect. Then I will make sure the cursor at the center, and make sure we have pivot point to be the 3D cursor. And after that scale shift Z, it will be, let's see what we have. So we scale first, I will extrude scale shift Z like this. We have this maybe a gear, but let's go and select the individual origin and scale around 0.7. Scale shift Z 0.75, scale shift Z 0.9, and now we have this gear. So if you want to make this radius smaller, you can scale shift Z such as this. So I will make 2 options to shift D in X. I will duplicate again here, and make sure that we have some options to be here. And again we will move in the X axis, and maybe rotating it in the Z axis. And if you want to make some detail, you can scale it in the Z axis like this. And if you see the clipping, you can go to the view and start from here. Alright. And to this area also, we can scale on Z to make it like this or like this. So as you can see, there is a lot of types of gear, and each gear has its own type. And let's go to the subdivision surface, and if you apply the subdivision surface, you will see you have this shape. And there is a lot of another way that you can go to the bevel modifier. If we disable it, as you can see, I have to go to the bevel modifier and make sure you have applied the scale, and you can increase it or decrease it. But because we have a lot of edges, and a bevel will not work in this case, so let's go back to the subdivision surface, and you can add loop cuts to define your edges, and make sure that you apply the shading to be smooth to both like this. So there is a bonus that we will go here and choose the timeline, and we want it to be 100 second or frame, I mean. And make sure you are in this the first frame, it starts at 1, and it's 100, and we make sure that you are here. And let's go here and select this one, and I will insert a rotation. Go here in the 100 and rotate in Z, let's say 200 degrees. And let's insert another rotation. Go to first frame, choose this one and insert another rotation, and R, go to 100 frame and rotate it in the other direction, minus 200 degrees. So, and finally we'll insert a rotation, and let's play our animation. Let's play like this. As you can see, it's now working perfectly. And if you want to make it more accurate, you can choose each one and go to the graph editor, select all and press T to be linear, and go back to the 3D view. For this one also, you can choose the graph editor and select all and make sure it's linear. So let's see what we have here. Let's play our voiceless bar. Now it's playing and nothing, and it's looping like this. And if you want to make it looping, you can end in this one. I think it will work. Or you can end in 100. So if you end in around 99, it will work. Alright, and that was concluded for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. See you in the next lesson.